Hi, in this tutorial, we're going to look at how to stream to Twitch using your Webcaster X2. Now, the default settings on Webcaster is to stream using the standard HD settings that Twitch specifies. So that would be 1280 by 720p, 30 frames per second, and 2 megabits per second. Now, you can change that in the preferences in your Webcaster, and I'll show you how to do that. You just need a mouse and a monitor connected to make changes to the preferences settings. The first thing you're going to want to do is choose the platform. Of course, there's Facebook, YouTube, Twitch, or AV Studio. There's multiple platforms. So the first thing we're going to do is choose a platform. Now, there's two ways to do that. You can just click on the multifunction power button, and you'll cycle through the different platforms. Or you can choose using your mouse and connected monitor. So I'm just going to change views so you can see that. Okay, so you can see that AV Studio is the selected platform. It really, Webcaster just remembers whatever you had selected previously. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to click up here in the corner and get the welcome page back so that I can choose a platform. And just click on Twitch. Now you see here, this is the IP address of this actual Webcaster unit. And I'm going to want to take this IP address and put it into a web browser. And that's where I'm going to be inserting my stream key that I'm going to get from Twitch. So if you weren't seeing this, I'll just right click to make that go away. You could always click on this pairing code button right there, and it's going to come up again. So once you have the IP address of your Webcaster, whether you got it from the front screen on Webcaster or from your connected monitor, you're going to want to now put that into your web browser and go to that pairing page. So I'll just change views again. Now, here's where I have a tab open on my web browser, and you can see right here that I've typed in the IP address that appears on the front screen of Webcaster. I can type it in as http://, and then the IP address. You know, you don't always have to type in the whole URL into your web browser. I'm going to want to now copy and paste the stream key from my Twitch account into this pairing page. And here's where you're going to want to enter your Twitch stream key. So all you need to do is go to your dashboard in your Twitch account. And under settings, here under channels, I already have selected the page that has the stream key. And okay, once you click show key, you've got this message pop-up that is asking you to confirm that you know the risks of sharing your stream key. I'm just going to click I understand, because I am going to change this stream key as soon as I finish this recording. So I've just copied that now, and I'm going to go back to my Webcaster, the pairing page, and I'm going to paste it in right there and click submit. And that's it. Now my Webcaster is paired with my Twitch account. Very simple. Now, if you wanted to change the default settings, you could certainly do that and stream at a higher bit rate and a different frame rate. All you need to do is go back into preferences. Just click on preferences. And here you could change the encoding resolution. That's the default, so I could change it to 1920 by 1080 if I wanted to. I could also change the video bitrate. Right now, it's at 2000 kilobits per second. And there are some other settings here too as well. The one that is interesting here for the Twitch details, if we just select that, this is the streaming server. By default, we have it set to auto select. And you can choose one that's closer to your area. We're just going to leave that at auto select. And again, you could also manually put in your stream key here if you wanted to use either the pop-up keyboard to type it in manually, but you can see how that's a pretty lengthy number to try to be typing in. It's so much easier doing it using the web browser. I'll just right-click to get out of there. Now, of course, you could stop streaming just by clicking this button right here, or you could press the multifunction power button on Webcaster itself. The other way you could do it is if you had a keyboard attached to your Webcaster, you could hit the space bar and it would stop streaming as well. And if we want to unpair, we probably should stop streaming first. You just click here and yes, we want to unpair. And that's it. It's really very simple to stream to your Twitch account using Webcaster X2. Like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more training videos from Epiphan U. Bye for now.